So one thing I like to say is when you can't control your income, control your expenses, right? Control the controllables. And that is exactly what I'll be doing in today's video. Since I've been laid off, my income has kind of been all over the place. It's really unpredictable when I might actually receive income. Sometimes I've gone for weeks without income. It's just been a hot mess. So that's finally kind of settled down. I'm getting back to my roots, guys. I am doing a budget video for the month of October, and I'll be doing it on paper. So I'm getting back to the basics, all right? Let's get right into it. So welcome back to Single Mom Money. This is your place for building wealth, dodging debt, and learning practical everyday money tips for single moms. So as promised, I'm going to go over my October budget right now. I finally celebrated my 1 year brand anniversary. I launched my first video on YouTube on September 9th. So that was just here recently. It was super fun. I did most of that on IG, but in basically honor of hitting my 1 year, I have finally developed my own budgeting products. So if you all have an interest, feel free to check out my Etsy link in the description, but I will be using them. So you'll see exactly what I got going on. If you want to mimic it, feel free. Let's get into it, all right? Alrighty, so this is my budget worksheet. This is the worksheet I'll be using for the month of October as I prep for the month. So a couple of things to note. First, I do follow what's called zero-based budgeting. So with this particular method, you don't go into a new month with money. I know that sounds crazy, but what you should do for your prior month is basically zero out. So if you have any money remaining in your bank account, you want to move it to savings or to a sinking fund. If you don't know what a sinking fund is, I did a video about it, so I'll link it here. But essentially, you want your dollars to be doing something. You don't want them to co-mingle with your new month. So I mean, this is just a really good method. I think it has helped me tremendously, and it helps me go into a new month with a clean slate, right? So I am not confused about the $42 or $87 or whatever left back in my account. I know that money's being put to good use. The other thing that I'll be filling out, actually you can see the old one there, is this blank calendar template. So this is where I'll actually put in all of my bills and due dates and things like that. So again, I can just track and make sure things are happening, because your budget is just a plan. It's just a spending plan. This is what you think you'll spend during the month. So you'll lay all of that here, lay all of that out here in the budget column. And then as you actually spend, you know, you'll enter your actual amounts. And then the difference column just helps you see, are you doing a good job of budgeting? You know, are you gauging properly what your expenses and income are versus what's actually happening during the month? So as I go through the month, I will show you all some more about my budgeting bundle system that will help you figure all of that out. So don't worry. I've done enough talking about this budget worksheet. Let's do it. So here's October's budget, basically, in a nutshell. Again, it's just a plan right now because we don't know what's going to happen. But I did go ahead and put 10/20. So that's October 2020. And my mantra is money comes to me quickly and easily. So that's one of my favorite money mantras or affirmations. So again, you don't have to use anything money related, but I did. My goals are to apply to 10 jobs for the month of October, interview 3 times, and work out at least 15 days out of the month. So it's 31 days in October, so it's about half of the time I should be exercising, at least doing some cardio or something. I gotta get it in. So those are my goals and my affirmation. And then basically drop down to income. So income for me right now is my unemployment and child support. So I have been sort of consistently getting some sort of child support for the past 2 months, I believe, 2 or 3 months now. I would have to look back at my old worksheets. But anyway, so I'm going to count that as an income right now. And so this income totaled up is what
got this number here, all right? So this is the summary line. You'll see total income is 1424. Next after income is just my general housing expenses. So any sort of like utilities, mortgage, cable, internet, water, sewer, trash, those, you know, basic things. So those are my numbers there. Nothing like probably too crazy. I am in an apartment and the apartment is all electric. So I don't have like crazy utility bills like I've seen other people have. And as y'all know, if you watch my videos, I am in the South. I am in Georgia. So again, for me, compared to living in Michigan where I'm from originally, the utilities here are like nothing. So anyway, not to harp on that. So after your housing, you'll drop down to just living expenses. So this is gonna be things like gas, groceries, cell phone, blah, da, 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 as you can read there. So those are my numbers. My groceries are a little bit higher, and that's just because we're home all day now. And my son thinks he's supposed to have a snack like every 5 seconds. But my gas cost is much lower, so that's kind of taking up some of that hit, or taking some of that hit. My cell phone bill is supposed to be $30, but I find, at least last month, I went over. I think that's because I was going to the gym a lot and I was not switching to Wi-Fi. So I'm just gonna budget for 47. I'm gonna try to be more cognizant of that so that doesn't happen to me again, where I went over my $30 because I went over the allotted 3 gig amount. And then the rest is pretty basic. I'm not really spending anything on entertainment, childcare, or really clothing or beauty right now, because just none of that is happening. Our next big chunk and our last chunk is just everything else, right? So our other expenses and investments. So I do have renter's insurance, auto insurance, life insurance, my car payment, and my student loans, credit card. Unfortunately, owe taxes from last year, so I started paying on those. And then my gym costs. I did start going to the gym about a month ago. And honestly, when it comes to my health and wellness, I have a different set of rules for spending. I know a lot of people might see that as just like unnecessary because I'm unemployed right now. It does so much for my mental well-being, even more than my physical. I just, working out and lifting weights and just, I don't know. I know I've done the workouts at home and I've walked around my neighborhood and those were okay. And I still do a lot of those, but it's just something about being in the gym, especially when it comes to lifting weights, that just does something so good for my mental health. So, and that has really, quite honestly, been suffering a bit in the past couple months because it's just been a lot. So I am paying $10. Not that I have to, you know, give anybody a reason why I'm spending when I'm spending, but that is the reason why I've incorporated the gym costs there. And if you'll see my total expenses compared to my total income, my expenses outweigh my income. So I actually have to pay out $2,205. And then that leaves me with a negative difference of $781. So right now that difference is being made up via my emergency savings. So right before I got laid off, I saved about 4 months worth of living expenses. So this will be like the first month I might have to tap into that. So I'm hoping that won't last long, you know, i.e. the goals here for me to interview and hopefully land a job here soon, or just find some sort of alternative for work until I can get back into my normal profession. So that is my spending plan. The next thing I'm going to show you guys, actually, this is the old one. So this is September's template for a calendar. And I like to just lay out all my bills and pay dates. So I am going to fill in that same thing for the month of October. All right. So let's do it. Alrighty. So here is my October 2020 at a glance. I have basically mapped out where I received my unemployment. I do not get paid child support regularly, and I have no clue when that date might be, so that is not here. I also have in like some numbers for my car payment, and I know the due date and like my life insurance, but you'll see like my rent, I don't have an amount because I don't always know that until usually like a week or two before it's due. It'll be posted, and that number varies slightly. So I will fill that in once I know what it is, but this just kind of helps me have an overall picture of when things are due and what is due. And I will come in here and just kind of audit what I have going out and coming in. So this way I can keep track of it all. And as things are paid, you can go and like highlight, you know, take a highlighter and just say, hey, you know, the car payment actually got taken out of the account, so now I'm gonna highlight it. Or you can cross it off, whatever method you want to use, but I highly suggest you have some sort of way of just double checking and making sure bills are being paid and that they actually are posting to your account. Because I've done that a few times and got burned, especially around my student loans. Like, I thought they were being auto debited and something happened, or the card expired, or I replaced the card and forgot about it, and it never looked like I thought it was a happening auto debit, and it wasn't, or never posted. Basically, long story short, you need a system to audit and make sure things are happening as they should. So that's that. And then also I just kind of keep track of, and I don't know these numbers yet, but like my cash back and my rebate card. So I've gotten a rebate card from Costco and one from Comcast. And then I get cash back on two different cards that I have, credit cards I have. So I like to just keep a tally of those, because around, usually either around my birthday, which is in the first quarter of the year, or the last quarter of the year for the holidays, I will use that cash back money for like gifts or whatever. So I do like to keep just a running tally of it to see what I have. So I did the same thing for September, and I'm going to show you all what I'll be doing next time we see each other. So I have an expense tracker, which again is just a way for me to audit. So not only will I be keeping track on my calendar, making sure things are posting to my account as I spend or get money, I will keep an ongoing balance of what's in my account here. And I will actually mark if when things are paid off and done, all right? So I'm not gonna show the expense tracker just yet because I don't have any October expenses just yet. But as that happens, I will do a mid-month budget update so you all can see how the magic all works. All right, so that is it for my October budget. I hope you all enjoyed. And check me out, you know, check me out on Instagram. Check me out on Facebook, Single Mom Money. Instagram is single_mom_money. And then check out my Etsy shop too at Single Mom Money. All right. That's October, y'all. See ya.
All right, so that is all for today. I hope you all liked me getting back to my roots and just writing out that budget, right? There are numerous tools and techniques. I just would say pick a particular tool or technique that really resonates with you and just be habitual about following it, right? It's all about building those good financial habits, and then we can kind of branch out into doing different things. If you liked what you saw here today, obviously, like I mentioned earlier, those the link for those products will be in my description for my Etsy shop. Super excited about that. It was really fun creating this for you all. I hope you found this video helpful. As always, that's what I aim to do all the time. And if you liked it, feel free to give me a like, share this video, and or I should say subscribe, right? So we'll be doing more of this, and I just really appreciate all the love I've gotten. You all continue to follow me and follow my journey. It has been quite the ride, but we're getting it done, all right? So go be great, budget buddies. This is Danielle signing off, and I hope you have a fantastic week. Take care of yourself, and besitos. Mwah, mwah, mwah.